All these four memory types, of course, have their drawbacks and their advantages. You see, the organ of the musician is the ear. So consequently, the auditory memory should be the basis. Yes, there's no question about that. If we, in the first place, can imagine the music in a lively enough fashion in our inner ear, we ought to be able to reproduce it on the piano without pitch. Yes? None of us is in that happy state. Yes? In that case, we could also produce it with any kind of fingering, yes, and on any kind of piano, and there shouldn't be any problems, yes? So if our inner ear were lively enough, then the auditory memory would be sufficient. But even people with absolute pitch, you see, and even people with inner ear who can take a score and hear it very lively, and I'm one of them, I don't mind patting myself on the shoulder, when it comes to elite and under tension in particular, by golly, you E flat instead of D, you know? Perfectly idiotic things. Because, I don't know what, you see, you suddenly go blank, you're in a hearing.
Or you doubt.
Or you
that
doubt
what you're thinking
or
is really
what,
right,
yes,
and so
yes,
you play
yes,
the wrong
yes,
thing because what you're thinking couldn't possibly be right.
Yeah,
you know,
because
when
you
it really would have been.
I mean, the
yeah,
urge to go on, the urge for continuity, you see, forces you to play something, and it's the wrong thing. And then there comes the catastrophe. So, I mean, the auditory memory is of course it, but even that needs to be bolstered by all sorts of other things, yes? Now, Mr. Foster recently made a paradoxical statement. He auditioned somebody and he said,